Welcome to Real Reviews. This week's reviews are brought to you by thefilmgordon.com. Experience film through the eyes of a true film addict, me. And of course, I am Tim Gordon, editor-in-chief of thefilmgordon.com. And on this show, we discuss my views on upcoming films. You can also read or listen to past reviews on thefilmgordon.com. And this week on the show, we review Hillbilly Elegy, an upcoming drama directed by Oscar-winning director Ron Howard from a screenplay written by Vanessa Taylor based on the 2016 memoir of the same name written by J.D. Vance. Now, the film, of course, stars heavyweights Glenn Close, Amy Adams, Gabriel Basso, Haley Bennett, Frida Pinto, Bo Hopkins, and Owen Astolos. And, of course, this is a film that I've been hearing a lot of buzz about. Of course, anytime Ron Howard has a film that comes out in the award space, which it is late in the year, you've got to stand up and take attention, or take notice, I should say, and pay attention. And this film, of course, based on the memoir, Hillbilly Elegy, a memoir of family and culture in crisis from J.D. Vance. Vance, of course, is portrayed in this film by Gabriel Basso. And we pick the story up with him as a law student trying to apply to get a summer internship, but coming from a background where he was raised in Appalachian, this is not an easy task, and he's got a lot he has to overcome. You know, we find out much later in the film that he has a physically and verbally abusive parent played by Amy Adams. Her mother, played Maymaw, played by Glenn Close, you know, we find out through their family history that both the matriarch of his family, played by Close, as well as his own mother, have subjected him to amazing trauma in his life that he is trying to overcome. And I think part of what makes this story so compelling to me is that it's almost kind of a, you know, a journey that we all have of how our lives start. They don't necessarily have to end where they start, right? So it's kind of, you know, it's not where you're from, but it's where you're at sort of a situation. But sometimes a lot of the pain and hurt and disappointment that we suffer as young people, that behavior carries over, and we see it all film long as J.D. Vance is in his present tense, trying to deal with his mother, who is at this point hooked on drugs, and he's trying to stabilize his home situation in the middle of trying to kind of do interviews and try to find an opportunity that will help pay for his law school. So along the way, what you get are some amazingly engaging performances by Glenn Close and Amy Adams, who are dealing with their own trauma and are unaware of how their actions are affecting young JB, who's very sensitive, but is kind of stuck in the middle of kind of all this estrogen that he has to deal with. And he's still too young to really comprehend what's actually going on in his life. His girlfriend, played by Frida Pinto, is there to try to kind of help him along, but he doesn't really want to involve her in a lot of the madness that's going on in his life, so he's pushing her away. His sister in the story, played by Haley Bennett, is also, she sees what her brother's going through, but she also helps enable the mother as well. So there is a lot of family trauma, but I think part of what this story is it's very redemptive in nature, and it shows from J.D. Vance that before he can move forward and become the man he needs to be, he needs to reconcile the story of the two women who helped raise him. And I think Ron Howard, this is to me a departure from some of the things that he's done in the past. I know he's done tender films like Cinderella Man. He's done huge films like Apollo 13. This film just feels a little different because not only are you dealing with this, but you're also dealing with a story that we're in the middle of an election season and we're seeing the polarization of our country. And this film kind of is a window into trying to understand what some of these rural mainstream whites have gone through. It's a very different experience from the African-American experience or other experiences of people of color, but it's a experience filled with its share of challenges and pain and trauma as well. Hillbilly Elegy, I think the one thing that audiences will take away from this film is, well, actually a couple of things they'll take away. Two, one, I should say, excuse me, is that you have absolutely knocked it, dynamite performances, both from Glenn Close and Amy Adams, who have their share of hardware in their shelves and have been nominated multiple times by the Academy and other organizations that give out awards. And in a film like this, I think Close deserves an amazing look. You'll also find out if you get to the end of the film when they show the actual participants, the real people in this story, that whoever did the costumes and makeup, they were spot on. They had these characters looking almost identical to the real life participants in the story. So kudos to them for everything they've done. Basso's performance, which is kind of mixed between a younger actor who plays him as well as Basso who plays him as an adult, I think does a fine job, but he is clearly overshadowed by these two female titans that just kind of in each scene they're in, and there are a couple of really tender, heartbreaking scenes that happen in cars in this film, so just be on the lookout for that as well. Ron Howard, kudos to him. Howard, who is one of my favorite directors, always stays low-key, but if you look at his filmography, he always churns out one amazing piece of work after another. Hillbilly Elegy is another film that he can be proud of to add to his resume. I gave this film a strong B. I really liked a lot of what this film had to say, and I think it's the sort of story for people who want to look back and look back over their own childhood to see the people that shaped them, just as JD figured out the two ladies or had to reconcile the two ladies that helped shape him. So Hillbilly Elegy will be on Netflix. I think it debuts on November 24th. You can check it out on the channel. And as we tell you guys in closing every week, please see something good at the movies. Hillbilly Elegy is definitely worth a look, if not for these two powerhouse performances, as well as, Tom Hanks. It's not Tom Hanks. It's Ron Howard's tremendous directing ability in this story and in this film as well. You guys take care, and I'll see you on the other side.